Hi, welcome to Sunil Maths Tutorial. Linear Algebra class number 3. In this video, we learn about a theorem, one of the very important theorem in subspaces. Let us see the statement. Let V of F be a vector space and W subset are equivalent to V. The necessary and sufficient condition for W to be a subspace of V are alpha comma beta belongs to W implies alpha minus beta belongs to W. A belongs to F, alpha belongs to W implies A alpha belongs to W. This theorem is necessary and sufficient condition for a subspace to be a, for a non-empty subset, for a subset to be a subspace. Yes? What is subspace? Subspace. It is also known as vector space. V of F is a vector space, W is subset to V. If W is itself, if W is itself a vector space over the same field capital F with respect to the same operations defined in V, then we say that W is a subspace of V. Subspace definition. V of F is a vector space. W is a non-empty subset of V. If W is itself a vector space over the field capital F with respect to the same operations defined in V, then W is known as subspace of V. And also, every vector space has at least two subspaces. One is zero space, second one is itself. Every vector space has at least two subspaces. One is zero vector space, the second one is V itself. These are known as trivial subspaces. These are known as trivial subspaces of the vector space. If any another subspace exists, they are known as non-trivial subspace. Yes, that is the subspace behind the subspace definition. Now the theorem is necessary and sufficient condition for a set to be a subspace. To be a subspace. Let us start. Given that V of F be a vector space, V of F be a vector space, and W is subset or equivalent to V, we have to prove that W is a subspace of V of F implies and implied by W satisfies the conditions or the properties. W satisfies the conditions. First one, alpha comma beta belongs to W implies alpha minus beta belongs to W. And the second one, A belongs to F comma alpha belongs to W implies A alpha belongs to W. This is our aim. We wish to prove that W is a subspace of V of F implies and implied by W satisfies the conditions. Alpha comma beta belongs to W implies alpha minus beta belongs to W. A belongs to F, alpha belongs to W implies A alpha belongs to W. You observe that. First, we assume that W is a subspace of V of F. We prove these conditions. In the converse part, we assume these conditions and we prove that W is a subspace of V of F. Let us take the first part. Suppose W is a subspace. W is a subspace of V of F. By the definition of subspace, then W is itself a vector space over capital F with respect to same operations, defined in V. This is the definition of subspace. Suppose W is a subspace of V of F, it means W is itself a vector space over the field F with respect to the same operations defined in V. We know that by the definition of vector space, W with respect to plus is an abelian group, and it satisfies the second major property, scalar multiplication property, holds in V, by the definition of vector space, W with respect to plus is an abelian group and scalar multiplication property holds in V. You observe the procedure. We assume that W is a subspace. Every subspace is itself a vector space. Every vector space is an abelian group. Under addition. And it satisfies the scalar multiplication property. There is a link between every step. If you observe that link, then it is very easy to learn. Observe that. Right? Let us continue. Let us take alpha comma beta belongs to W, which implies alpha comma minus beta belongs to W. Because you observe that W with respect to, plus is an abelian group. It is an abelian group means every element of W has additive inverse. Because of addition is the operation. Every element of W has additive inverse. So we use the inverse axiom for second element. By inverse axiom with respect to addition in W. We apply the inverse axiom with respect to addition in W. So now apply the closure axiom. Alpha plus of minus beta belongs to W. This step break. Here we use inverse axiom. In this step we use closure axiom. This is nothing but alpha minus beta belongs to W. Which is the required first condition? Again, since you observe that, we write here, scalar multiplication property holds in V because it is a vector space. Holds in W. What is this? That is, A belongs to F. Alpha belongs to W implies, A alpha belongs to W. Now you observe that from these two conditions. Therefore, W satisfies the required conditions. This is the first part of the theorem. We prove the converse also. Again, I repeat, observe that. It takes only 1 minute. Suppose W is a subspace of V of F. Every subspace is itself a vector space. Therefore, W is an abelian group under addition and W satisfies the scalar multiplication property. Take two elements, alpha beta belongs to W. Apply the inverse axiom for the second element, alpha comma minus beta belongs to W. Apply the closure axiom, A plus of minus beta belongs to W. Alpha minus beta belongs to W, which is the required first condition. Again, since scalar multiplication property holds in W, because it is itself a vector space, W is itself a vector space, so scalar multiplication property holds in V. Therefore, that is, A belongs to F, alpha belongs to W implies, A alpha belongs to W. It means, W satisfies the required conditions. Now, let us go for the converse part. converse. Converse means we assume the second part and we prove that W is a subspace of V of U. Suppose W satisfies the conditions. W satisfies the conditions. First one, alpha comma beta belongs to W implies alpha minus beta belongs to W. Let it be equation number one. And A belongs to F. Alpha belongs to W implies A alpha belongs to W. Equation number two. Equation number two. Observe. We assume that W satisfies two conditions. Alpha beta belongs to W implies alpha minus beta belongs to W. A belongs to F, alpha belongs to W implies A alpha belongs to W. Now we prove that W is a subspace of V of F. Now we prove that. We prove that W is a subspace. W is a subspace of V of F. Right? From equation 1. From equation 1. Let us replace beta by alpha. Let us replace beta by alpha. Then, I mean, you write instead of beta again alpha. Alpha comma alpha belongs to W. Implies alpha minus alpha belongs to W. Remember that. This is very simple. We replace the value. We replace the element beta by alpha. So you get alpha minus alpha belongs to W. Which implies 0 bar belongs to W. Which implies additive identity element. Additive identity element. Additive identity exists in W. Additive identity exists in W. Yes, again from equation 1. Again from equation 1. Instead of alpha, we take 0 bar. Instead of beta, we take alpha. We are again applying the same equation 1. But instead of alpha, write 0 bar. Instead of beta, write alpha. Belongs to W. Which implies as alpha minus beta belongs to W. 0 bar minus alpha belongs to W. Which implies minus alpha belongs to W. Minus alpha belongs to W implies as, that is, alpha belongs to W implies minus alpha belongs to W. What it means? Every element of W, every element of W has additive inverse. Has additive inverse in W. Observe that. We prove that additive identity exists in W. We prove that every element of W has additive inverse in W. Again from equation 1. Again from equation 1. Same. We use the same equation again. Take alpha comma beta belongs to W. Apply the inverse axiom first for the second element. Alpha comma minus beta belongs to W because every element of W has additive inverse in W. So for beta belongs to W, we have minus beta belongs to W. Now apply equation 1. Alpha minus of minus beta belongs to W. Which implies alpha plus beta belongs to W. Which implies W satisfies the closure axiom. W satisfies the closure axiom with respect to addition. With respect to addition. Now you observe that. We prove the closure axiom. We prove the identity axiom. We prove the inverse axiom. Yes, let us continue. Since W is subset to V. Since W is subset to V, that is, every element of W is an element of V. Is an element of V. Every element of W is an element of V. And elements of V. Elements of V satisfies. Elements of V satisfies. Associative. Elements of V satisfies. Associative and commutative axioms. Commutative axioms. With respect to addition. Observe that every element of W is an element of V. And elements of V satisfies associative and commutative axioms with respect to addition. Therefore, elements of W. Elements of W are also satisfies associative, are also satisfies associative and commutative axioms with respect to addition because W subset to V. Now you observe that W satisfies closure axiom, associative axiom. We prove that identity exists. We prove that inverse exists. We prove that commutative axiom. Therefore, W with respect to plus is an abelian group. W with respect to plus is an abelian group. Right? Now we use equation number 2. From equation 2, what is equation 2 here? A belongs to F. Alpha belongs to W. Implies A alpha belongs to W. That is scalar multiplication property. Holds in W. Now you observe that W satisfies the two major properties of the vector space. W with respect to 2 plus is an abelian group. And scalar multiplication property holds in W. Again, since W subset to V, the other axioms of vector space are trivially holes in W. Now you observe that W with respect to 2 plus is an abelian group. W satisfies the scalar multiplication property. The other axioms of vector space are trivially holes in W. Therefore, W is a vector space. W is a vector space over capital F. And W is subset or equivalent to V. W is itself a vector space over capital F and W is subset to V. Therefore, we conclude that W is a subspace. W is a subspace of V of F. Now, you observe that in the first part, we take W is a subspace. We prove the conditions. In the second converse part, we take that W satisfies two conditions and we prove that W is a subspace of V of F. Hence, we conclude that W of F is a subspace of V of F. Implies and implied by W satisfies two conditions. The first one, alpha comma beta belongs to W, implies alpha minus beta belongs to W. The second one, A belongs to F, alpha belongs to W, implies A alpha belongs to W. This completes the proof. Hence proved. One of the very very important theorem for university examinations. Keep learning. In the next video, we'll learn the next theorem depends upon the same subspace.